multiplying decimals with models. In math, it is important to conceptually understand what exactly a math problem is asking you to do and what the answer means. Models can help us build our conceptual understanding. Let's look at how to multiply decimals using a model. Our first problem that we're going to look at is 3/10 × 7/10. When multiplying decimals using a model, we're going to start by converting our decimals into fractions. The way you read a decimal is the way you write the fraction. 3/10 is equivalent to the fraction 3/10, and 7/10 is equivalent to the fraction 7/10. When modeling multiplication of decimals, we use a grid. For this problem, we will use a 10x10 grid because both denominators are 10. If the denominators were not 10, we would need to scale up or scale down so that we could create an equivalent fraction that had a denominator with a power of 10, such as 10, 100, 1000, etc. Then we could adjust the grid to match the denominator. For example, if the denominator was 100, we could use a 100x100 grid. Okay, back to the problem of 3/10 × 7/10. To create our model to help us solve our problem, we're going to start with our first fraction of 3/10. Remember, the numerator of a fraction tells us the parts and the denominator tells us how many are in the whole. Let's use the vertical columns of the 10x10 grid to model 3/10. Since the numerator is 3, we will shade in 3 of the 10 vertical columns. Now we can model the second fraction, which is 7/10. This time we're going to look at the 10 rows that make up the grid. The numerator of the second fraction is 7, so we will need to shade in 7 of the 10 rows. Once we are done representing the two fractions on the grid, we're going to look at the double shaded or overlapping area of the grid to find our answer. To write our answer, we first need to consider how many squares are on the 10x10 grid to determine our denominator. There are 100 squares on the grid, so that means that our denominator for our answer will be 100. To determine our numerator, we will need to look at how many squares are in the double shaded area. For this problem, we have 21 squares that are double shaded, making our numerator 21. Now we know that our answer is 21 over 100. Since the original problem asked us to multiply decimals, we need to convert our answer back into decimals. 21/100 is equivalent to the decimal 21/100. Let's do one more problem. 3 × 3/10. Notice this problem has a whole number being multiplied by a decimal. This problem is asking us to find 3 groups of 3/10. Again, let's start by converting our decimal of 3/10 to a fraction. When we do that, we get 3/10. Since our denominator is 10, we will use a 10x10 grid. Since we need 3 groups of 3/10, we're going to start by shading in 3 of the 10 vertical columns. This makes up 1 group of 3/10. The problem wants us to find 3 groups, so we need to create 2 more groups of 3/10. Let's go ahead and do that. We will shade another group of 3 vertical columns, which gives us our second group, followed by the last set of 3 columns, giving us our 3rd group of 3/10. Now that we have our 3 groups of 3/10, we need to look at how many total squares we shaded. Since we used a 10x10 grid, we had a total of 100 squares. After shading in 3 groups of 3/10, we have 90 of those 100 squares shaded. This means that our answer is 90 over 100, or 90/100, which we can also write as 9/10.